sustainable harvesters. What you're standing in is about 12,000 square feet of controlled environment greenhouse space. In this space, we can grow up to 7,000 heads of lettuce in every week, utilizing growing techniques called aquaponics. We grow a bunch of different varieties of leafy green lettuces, and we distribute that to restaurants all throughout Houston, San Antonio, Austin, Dallas, and even in Louisiana, including New Orleans and Baton Rouge.
Sustainable Harvesters was really formed out of the necessity and the need for fresh and local produce in the Houston market specifically. We noticed that there was new restaurants popping up left and right, and all of them always had a gear towards local, fresh, and sustainable produce that they were sourcing from. When we dove deeper, we realized there was only a few partners actually supplying these restaurants and these chefs with the products they needed. That's why we landed on growing lettuce. Every restaurant has a salad, and every chef really likes a fresh, new-looking green.
We seed all of our lettuce by hand, and we start them on these grow trays right here. So this grow tray has 162 spots of a 1-in-1-inch cube that we ultimately put one seed in and let them germinate in the dark for about 2 days. After that time period, they have access to the sunlight. They're gonna grow their first leaf, and specifically with lettuce, that first leaf is called a radicle. So once they hit that radicle stage, we bring them into the sunlight and we ultimately leave them under LED lights for about 2 to 3 weeks. When they get to about this size or a little bit younger or a little bit older, we actually bring these trays down to the very back of the greenhouse, where each one of these will pop out on a bed of pegs, exposing its cubed material. This cubed material is made of 99% peat moss with a 1% elastic polymer, giving it a sponge-like effect, allowing us to submerge this root structure into water for the life of the product. So the first stage in every day is harvesting.
Harvesting is really the only thing that we do, harvest and plant, and we try and do that as sustainable as possible by recirculating that water, by utilizing the wastewater that we collect to our compost beds, and really try and use as many efficiencies in labor and planting as possible. And so when we were deciding what we should be called, we really thought about the two words that make us different, or at least make us what we are, and that is sustainable, and that is harvesters.
When we do harvest in the morning, it's as easy as pulling this entire board out of the water and carefully bringing it to our food preparation area, where we'll ultimately take each one of these heads of lettuce off of this board by pulling them out, exposing just a few of the bad leaves that might be there. When we put these roots around this, it gives a shelf life of close to 3 weeks in your refrigerator. Now, when we remove the boards, we leave a gap up in the front, and then that allows us to push all the boards towards us here, our harvest area, and stack new boards in the back utilizing our germination cubes. So we'll pack it in these trays that we call our transfer trays, ultimately packing one variety in each one of these trays, giving us the ability to pack all 7 varieties with a couple of these and keep them in our cooler to crisp up. Then it's time to pack our lettuce and make our mixed cases.
So early on, when we were really trying to find that market for our products, we called upon Texas A&M and Prairie View A&M to come out and give us a little insight about farming. They looked at us and said, you know, you two are young folk. You should really go home and check out this new way of farming called aquaponics. That night we went home, Googled aquaponics. The next day when we came out here, we looked at each other and we said, this is our goal. This is gonna be what we're gonna try and establish in this market.
So now it's really time to get into the aquaponics side and what makes us different than most traditional growers out there. The basic definition of aquaponics is the combination between aquaculture, raising fish or freshwater fish in a controlled environment, and hydroponics, which is growing plants in a soilless environment. So we utilize both ecosystems working together to simultaneously create the nutrients and ultimately remove the nutrients in the form of uptaking and growing their beautiful leafy green leaves. So these tilapia are the real engine to our motor. They create that nutrient in its raw form called ammonia. And they create that by excreting a waste product after we feed them every day 2 to 3 times. Our next filtration are biofilters. These are a simple baffle system that separates out the solids from the liquid ammonia or broken apart ammonia. So after it removes its 50%, that other 50% of that waste heads down to our second filter we like to call our living filter, so that the water passing below this walkway into our grow beds is clean of any solid debris and just really rich in ammonia, which the plants can ultimately take up in the form of that nitrate and remove it from the system before that water flows directly back to the lowest point in our system, where we equipped a pump sending it 8 feet directly above so that we can have fresh water going directly to those fish tanks, creating a closed loop recirculatory aquaculture system by the scientific definition. In finding this land, we were really lucky in the fact that we could partner with the Houston Oaks Country Club that was gearing their menu and their entire members' dinner and lunch service to local farm fresh grown produce. And that inspired us to really build our greenhouse and really promote that awesome farm to table experience to a whole nother level, which we have a total of 5 greenhouses, 12,000 square feet of working greenhouse, and the expansion of another 8,000 square feet coming in this summer. After securing the land, we really noticed that the most important part about our system is a level pad site. All of our water has to be level so that we can flow it from 100 feet from one side to the other without having much variance in the depth of that water. So starting with a very flat base allows us to build upon that a very structural system and a very efficient and ultimately sustainable system. A lot of the hurdles in the beginning days of sustainable harvesters weren't so much with the system, it was really scaling up at the appropriate time to supply the demand in the market. And so we chose the 12 varieties of lettuce that were found nowhere in the market, and that includes our green butterhead and red butterhead, green and red oak leaf, green and red Lola Rosa, our summer crisp, red and green romaine, and of course, everyone's favorite, Boston Bib. So our baby lettuces were really what we marketed and promoted to our restaurants, and they caught on like wildfire. So the best advice I believe in starting any type of agricultural enterprise or entrepreneurial adventure is to really know your market. Reach out to your local colleges of agriculture or even your chefs at your local restaurants and get their point of view and their perspective. They will tell you the answers that you need to know to start and build up your initial business plan. Consistency is key. And so we are realistic with these chefs, but we are also as consistent with them as possible. We're gonna be here not only in the winter and the great growing seasons of the spring, but we'll be there in the summer when people want that salad, or in the fall when they really want something fresh and healthy for their diet. Food is medicine, and growing a healthy and a fresh product for people to consume that are really trying to be as healthy as possible really gives me the passion to keep on going. I think the most rewarding part is going out to those farmers markets and seeing these kids and parents of these kids try something new. As a kid, I never ate salads, and to see a kid grab a head of lettuce that might have never had a salad before, see those roots, get interested about the way it was grown, and then ultimately follow that interest back to the kitchen, hearing those parents come back and say, "You have transformed our kids' diet." I think that is one of the most rewarding parts of this system and part of this experience that we've been a part of. I think land is important because you can't create more of it.
as we move closer and closer to the urban environments, there is less people living in these rural environments, which means more and more food needs to be moved into the urban environments. And so a growing technique like aquaponics or hydroponics allows you to really use a minimal amount of space to grow a maximum amount of produce. We are here for a short amount of time, but the land is here for eternity. It's here for a large amount of time, and really the things that we do to it today impact it hundreds and hundreds of years down the road. I think that it might not be visible to see the damage that we are doing to some of the land out there, but being mindful of that and utilizing land for an original purpose like farming or agriculture is something that I think we need to move back towards. Having a care and a need for this land, even though we might not be utilizing it as much as we used to, we need to be proactive and really be sustainable in all ways that we have land management. Landio, land is opportunity.